what is the difference between the three groups, the protozoa, the parazoa, and the metazoa? The protozoans. The protozoans are considered as the ancestors of the animals because they are simple, because they are unicellular, and some of them are colonial. They lack a well-organized organization. They do not have tissues. It gave rise to, it evolved into the second group, that is the parazoa. What are the characteristics of the parazoa? The parazoans are, number one, they are the group of animals that do not have a specialized tissue. As you can see over here, that these are just a group of cells, just a bunch of cells, just a stable configuration of the similar cells. And you can see over here, there's a layer, the pinacocytes, there's a layer of pinacocytes, there's a layer of guanocytes, that is called as pinacoderm and the guanoderm, and just a group of two layers. They are not organized into any organs or systems. Okay, next. The only phylum that belongs to this group is the phylum Porifera, or you can commonly call it as sponges. And they are not symmetric. They do not have any symmetry. As you can see over here, you cannot divide it into any plane of division. You cannot divide it by any plane. They are asymmetric. They do not have a well-defined symmetry. Okay, thanks. The second group, which is considered to have been evolved from the parazoa, is the metazoa. This is the group of animals that have specialized tissue, specialized organs, systems, as it gives rise to the higher and higher animals, or the chordates, eventually the chordates. They have specialized tissues. Now you can see over here, they have ectoderm, they have the mesoderm, they have the endoderm, they have the specialized tissues. And they have well-defined system. All the phyla that other than the Porifera that belong to this group, that may include in sequence. After Porifera, there are coelenterates, the cnidarians, there are the platyhelminthes, the flatworms, the roundworms, aschelminthes, the annelids, arthropods, mollusks, echinoderms, and eventually into the phylum Chordata, all the phyla of all the groups of the phylum Chordata. Again, next, comparing the symmetry of the both, the parazoans were asymmetric over here, whereas the metazoans, they are either radially symmetrical, as in the case of jellyfish, or they are bilaterally symmetrical, as in case of planaria. Radial symmetry means they have more than one plane of division, and bilaterally symmetrical means they have only a single plane of division that divides the body into two equal identical halves. Okay, these are the two groups. And if you talk about the evolutionary sequence, let's see again what is the evolutionary sequence. The protozoa, the ancestors of the animals, the parazoa, the transition group of animals that links the ancestral protozoans with the multicellular, well-organized, eukaryotic group of animals, that is the metazoa.